So now McNabb, he's hit on 58% of his passes, has thrown 5 touchdowns and 5 interceptions. He ranks 3rd in the NFC in passing yards. And he'll throw it on 1st down. And that's Anthony Armstrong down the middle of the field. He's out to the 43-yard line.
Nice job coming out play action. Anthony Armstrong, he's got such great speed that he's able to threaten down the field, and that's what creates the separation for him. And a good pocket in the middle, a good way to start if you're a quarterback. You like coming out and getting a high percentage completion right off the bat, and that's what the Redskins were able to do on that first play of the game.
False start, number 75, offense. 5-yard penalty, still 1st down.
Walt Anderson, our referee today. Ryan Terrain coming off a 100-yard rushing game against Indianapolis last week. Armstrong has replaced Joey Galloway, starting his 3rd straight game. And up front, another challenge for Trent Williams, a rookie, going toe-to-toe with Julius Peppers. And that's Terrain, who's up to midfield on his 1st carry of the afternoon. Chicago defensively ranks 8th overall in the NFL. Peppers in his 1st year has a couple of sacks, had an interception against his old team Carolina. Lance Briggs missed last week with an ankle injury. He's back in there today. And in the secondary, Tim Jennings starts for a 4th straight time there without Zachary Bowman, who got hurt last week. Maybe a yard pickup for Terrain. It'll bring up 3rd down and short for the Washington Redskins on their opening possession of the game.
And you talk about this Bears defense and coming off a really disappointing game last week against Seattle, and Julius Peppers was a non-factor in that ball game. He just seemed very disinterested in the game itself. In fact, that seemed to be shared by the other 10 guys on defense, because it was a dispirited effort. And they're going to play a lot better in this game.
Short job. Incomplete. Santana Moss looking for a flag against Jennings, and he didn't get it. Their receivers among all teams in the NFL, but 2 big drops on that last series by Armstrong and Cooley. And after a 20-yard punt, Forte on 1st down, still on his feet, and picks up maybe a yard. Redskins defensively. Kamoyatu in the middle. They've gone to the 3-4. Arakpo has already picked up 5 sacks. Rocky McIntosh back after missing last week with a concussion. And keep an eye on number 30, LaRon Landry. What a year he's having. It's Jay Cutler up at the top of your screen and taking the direct snap. Is Devin Hester, and that did not fool the Washington defense.
No, you take a look at this right now, and Mike Martz, I mean, he's looking at that play sheet just not knowing what he should call. And, you know, fans want to see him call more runs, but as we've seen again here today, there's been 3 runs called and virtually no yardage to speak of. And when you're constantly faced with 2nd and 10, 3rd and 10, when you've called running plays, it's hard to keep calling running plays, especially when you're Mike Martz and you have such strong confidence in your ability to put your quarterback in a position to make plays down the field. But the issues up front have been a real concern, both passing and running.
Dead last in 3rd down conversions, and that number's on the way down as Cutler is sacked. Again, that is 28 sacks allowed by the Bears, most in the league.
You can see the push right here. Albert Haynesworth, he's just going to go right through the left side and pushes him right back. Chris Williams right back into Jay Cutler. And Arakpo coming off the edge. And, you know, the edge
struggling again on offense, again surrendering a sack. But both teams slow to get it started on offense. Terrain across the 40 and picks up maybe 2, tripped up by Matt Toina. Toina has replaced Tommy Harris, who went to 3 straight Pro Bowls, but now he comes off the bench.
Yeah, Toina, I think he's come in and really has done a nice job. He's a big body there in the middle. Tommy Harrison talking with Lovie Smith the other day, he said we still expect him to play at a much higher level, even though he hasn't played at that level in quite some time.
Harris has checked in the game. And a nice throw, and this time a catch is made down the middle of the field to the backup tight end, Fred Davis, who got a lot of playing time after Cooley broke an ankle last season.
Trent Williams, the rookie left tackle, does a good job here on Julius Peppers. And, you know, Donovan throwing another one of those low balls. If he's able to get it up into the arms of Fred Davis and let him run, he's able to pick up considerable more yardage. But Fred Davis is one of those guys who they really do expect a lot from. And he was slow developing in the old system, and he's been a little slow coming along in Shanahan's offense. But I think he's got big days ahead of him.
Well, they lay it off for Cooling. And he's chased down by Tolina. That'll be a pickup of five. And let's send it again back to Los Angeles to Kurt Menefee.
After that 0-5 start, the Niners trying to make it two wins in a row today at Carolina. Alex Smith hooking up with Vernon Davis for a 53-yard reception down at the one-yard line. But that's okay. Same two hooked up very next play for the touchdown. 7-3 right now, Niners on top. Tom, Troy, and Pam.
Kurt, thank you. Second down and five. No score. Midway through the opening quarter at Soldier Field. Sellers out of the backfield has a first down to the 22-yard line.
Thought it was interesting. Lovie Smith said Mike Sellers was, in his opinion, the most impressive offensive player for the Redskins that he had watched this week on film. And I think that's a compliment to Mike Sellers as opposed to a disparaging comment to the other guys. But he does it all. He's such a versatile player. He's an excellent blocker from the fullback position, and then he catches the ball well coming out of the backfield.
Terrain leaps over the first would-be tackler, Julius Peppers, and then is chopped down for a four-yard loss. There are flags on the play.
Holding, number 77, offense, 10-yard penalty, first down.
That's a longtime Saint, Jamal Brown.
Well, this offensive line for the Redskins, they've had their share of problems this year as well, trying to develop some continuity. We'll see if we can see the hold here. Looks like it might have been there on Julius Peppers. You see him as Peppers goes inside. Jamal Brown's the one who gets the hold on him. But, you know, last week in that loss to the Indianapolis Colts, both Trent Williams and Jamal Brown, they had their hands full.
McNabb has it intercepted. And racing the other way is DJ Moore for a touchdown. Hard right up the gut up to the 34-yard line.
Boy, so run hard is exactly right, Tom. I mean, this guy, I think he always runs hard, and he's trying to make the most of an opportunity. You know, we talk about it when we've had Redskins, everybody does, with the injury problems that he's had. But now coming into this game, just over 60 rushing attempts, you know, now is the time where the body starts to feel some of those hits on a weekly basis. And I think now we're going to get a pretty good gauge as to how well he's holding up physically.
McNabb looking down the field, and he'll slide up to the 36-yard line. It'll bring up third down and two.
Well, pretty good coverage this time by the Chicago Bears. They get McNabb outside the pocket, and, you know, obviously plenty of time to get the ball out of his hands, but the Bears do a good job of recognizing it, and that's going to be important. And even old Julius Peppers, he had gotten about 15, 20 yards down the field dropping into coverage. Little different defense today from the one we saw last week in that loss against Seattle.
open across the middle, Santana Moss, and that's a first down.
The defense when he's not on the field.
Screen to Cooley. Cuts it back to the inside, escaped a tackle from Julius Peppers and picks up close to nine. Cooley, another injured Redskin last week. Suffered a concussion early in a game, stayed in the game, and finally had to leave in the fourth quarter.
And you just kind of wonder, I mean, he had that drop there on that first possession, and I'm not suggesting that he shouldn't be playing. But you don't see Chris Cooley drop that many passes. You know, you just wonder if maybe he is still not quite 100%.
Peppers to the sideline on a third and a yard. Cooley again. Boy, when he's healthy, there might be some guys around the league that get a lot more pub. But Cooley is rock solid at that tight end position.
Well, he's just got a good feel. You know, I don't know that Chris Cooley's healthy, though, right now. I mean, he's not moving particularly well. He did a great job on that last play of seeing Tim Jennings out in front of him and giving Donovan a place to go with the ball for the first down. You're going to see as he comes across the formation, Tim Jennings right there. But then he pulls up, so Donovan has a place to go. But you talk about him, he's a valuable guy to this offense. As good as he is a receiver, I think he's an excellent blocker, something that I think goes unnoticed. But he is able to block the point of attack very well in the run game.
Strong running again from Terrain. Boy, is he impressive.
You see, Pisa Tino Isamoa, he's the one who comes in and levels the hit on Chris Cooley. It didn't look like it was a blow to the head. He was going off looking as if it might have been something to his lower body, but obviously a concern based on the fact that he played last week after getting head in the hit in the head, as you said, and that's always a concern when you've got a guy coming back from that type of injury.
Washington trailing 7-0, but on the move. Terrain spun down at the 23-yard line.
You know, you talk about the Bears and Mike Martz, and when you're not running the ball particularly well and then getting away from it pretty quickly because of your philosophies and what you want to do then offensively. You know, the Redskins aren't that type of offense. Mike Shanahan, Kyle Shanahan, if they're struggling running the ball early, like they did last week against the Indianapolis Colts, they're going to stick with it. I mean, they're going to continue to try to pound the ball and have it pay dividends when you get into the fourth quarter. That's what this offense is built around.
So Cooley checks back in, ninth play of the drive. Good protection, wide open, and a touchdown to Santana Moss.
Develop some type of continuity and rhythm.
They fake it to Chester Taylor, and a throw a little bit high for Johnny Knox.
You know, you can see some of what Mike Martz is trying to do is, you know, when you've got an offense that's struggling, every single play becomes a challenge. You know, when you're playing at your best, you just go play. You're not thinking about trying to complete every pass or trying to get first down so much. You're just letting it all unflow. And I think that the important thing is him trying to get Cutler some easy completions. But as we saw on that last play, nothing is easy right now.
Second down, blitz coming. And somehow Cutler gets out of trouble, but runs into more in the form of Rocky McIntosh.
You're going to see a lot of pressure right here, just coming right up on the outside and then pushing the pocket inside as well, and just not a lot of places there for Cutler to move. And we've seen that a lot. Once Cutler gets on the move, I mean, he is quick to tuck it and then run into more danger. I mean, he had an area where he might have been able to pull it, maybe make something happen, or at least get up the field and avoid losing the yardage that he lost. Instead, he ran himself right into another sack.
Third and 15. Flag down, screen to Chester Taylor. And that picks up about 5 yards. Every single year.
Well, it sure is, and it's been a struggle each and every week for that Saints team.
Play action, great protection, and a good throw. And it's Anthony Armstrong to the Chicago 30-yard line.
Just a really nice job up front. A lot of times when you go play action, it's the best protection you can afford yourself up front, and he gets great protection on that play. And Anthony Armstrong running a deep crossing route, and this is a heck of a throw right here by Donovan McNabb, laying it over the linebackers and then into the arms of Anthony Armstrong. Anthony Armstrong got his chance to be a starter last week, and you know, a real flyer, and he's done a nice job with his opportunities.
And really, that's a story for a number of these Redskins. Not only Anthony Armstrong, who played, you know, in the intense football league, then went on to play in the Arena League, signed with Miami, was only there for a short time. The Redskins put him on their practice squad, and here he is a starter. And then you look at Terrain, who injured his knee with Denver in 08. Didn't play at all last year, and now after injuries to Portis and the release of Larry Johnson, he's here featured back.
Well, they're both well traveled. Armstrong more than Terrain, but they've been making an impact.
Urlacher's been making an impact for quite a while. Healthy again is Brian Urlacher. NFL Defensive Player of the Year going back to 05, broke his wrist in the first game of last season against Green Bay. And they're happy to have him back and healthy and playing like Brian Urlacher again. Blitz coming. Looked like Moss just lost his footing. Good start to the second quarter.
Boy, they needed that. They needed something positive to happen for him. Johnny Knox is a guy who Mike Martz just thinks is going to be exceptional within this offense because he has great speed and he has great quickness. Two things that are really required to play wide receiver within this scheme that Mike Martz employed.
Second down and 15. Good protection this time. The receiver fell down, Devin Hester, and nearly made the catch from his knees. So another third and long upcoming for Cutler and the Bears. And again, if you're just joining us, with Jay Cutler at quarterback, and remember, he missed a game after getting sacked 9 times against the Giants, left with a concussion, was sacked 6 times when he came back last week. 0 for his last 25 on third down.
Well, that's probably going to be 0 for 26 because there's not a lot of plays that allow you to convert on third and 15.
And he's sacked for the third time in a game. A Arakpo with number 6 on the year.
You're going to see Arakpo come off the edge, but you also got to see Chris Williams right here, the left guard, and the job that he does or doesn't do. He just, you know, you get the edge pressure, but then you've got to be able to step up. And Chris Williams now on 2 occasions has turned guys loose. That time
Bears back on offense, trailing 10-7. They have 1 first down so far today. London Fletcher on the tackle of Matt Forte.
These fans, they like the call, and they like the production there.
You know, but you and I were talking in the break, and I thought, you know, when you point out about sooner or later, it doesn't matter if you're running or passing, you have to block people. They had run the ball 3 times in the game for a total of 1 yard before that carry. And a good carry it was, a gain of 6. He'll do it again. And close to a first down is Forte, depending on the spot.
You know, I ran into some Bear fans last night, Tom, and was talking to them about their team, and what they said was, you know, probably echoed by all Bear fans, and that we need to run the ball. And that's kind of the mentality. I'm not saying they're wrong, but that's kind of the mentality around the league. is that whenever things aren't going well and you haven't run the ball, just run the ball and magically that changes everything. But the Bears have not been a good running team for quite some time. Matt Forte, you take the Carolina game out a few weeks ago, he's averaging 2.5 yards a carry.
They're going to run it 3rd and 1 yard. And just Chester Taylor has dropped for a loss. Haynesworth pretty active today.
You see the big man right here in the middle, 92, and he just moves right through Olin Krutz. And Lance look.
And a field goal the difference as Washington has the football with under 8 minutes to play until halftime and no running room for Terrain.
Well, we talked about it, Tom. The Redskins, you know, really, to have 10 points probably should have a lot more than that considering the field position that they've been afforded here in this first half. And there's no doubt, based on what we're seeing from the Bears offensively, that this defense is going to be held responsible for trying to keep them in the ballgame.
Again by Adonijé. Adonijé having his best season. He won the job over Mark Anderson during the preseason and has played very well.
Yeah, he really has. And, you know, it's primarily a special teams player, and then he got his opportunity to play on defense and doing a pretty good job. But I know Lovie Smith still expects more from that guy playing opposite of Julius Peppers. And Julius Peppers, as we know, he creates a lot of attention and people are going to slide protection to him, and it should free up some things for Israel Adonijé and whoever else lines up opposite.
3rd and 11, blitz coming, and it's batted at the line of scrimmage. 3 and out again for the Bears defense. Chris Harris delivered a lick on Donovan McNabb.
Yeah, the Bears, they dialed it up a little bit. You're going to see Chris Harris come in from the safety position, and Keelan Williams, who's a good blocker, he has to make a decision. Okay, who am I going to take? He takes the most dangerous.
But they're only down 3. Forte. Read beautifully by big number 97, Lorenzo Alexander.
You know, there's so many things that Mike Marks would like to be able to get to in this game. And if they can get protection, and that's obviously a big if, and it has been. But if they're afforded some protection, he's got some things that he feels that he can take advantage of with this secondary here of the Washington Redskins. Everyone else has. I mean, they've been giving up over 400 yards of offense or to the opposing offenses throughout the first 6 games of the season, and that's not by chance. I mean, there's some holes there, but I know it's frustrating right now for Mike Martz. He's trying to protect his quarterback and maintain some type of balance and can't get to those things.
Short drop, catch made by Hester. And you can't play it defensively any better than Carlos Rogers just did.
Oh, and this is, you know, we talked to Jim Haslett, and he said, hey, the reason we've been giving up so many yards is because we've played against Tony Romo and Matt Schaub and Aaron Rodgers and Peyton Manning and some awfully good offenses, and all that's true. And typically you're playing against pretty good offenses or pretty good quarterbacks each and every week. This might be that game to where they're able to come down considerably in the rankings.
Another 3rd down. 0-for-5 so far. Batted down. Crowd wanted a flag, and LaRon Landry knocked it away.
Well, you living in the North Texas area, that area is psyched for the Texas Rangers.
Nice play there by Tommy Harris. Of course, you've always been there for him. You've never been a bandwagon guy.
You know, I'm for a lot of teams. I'm for winners is the way I look at it.
Well, it's like the email, you know, you sent me last week. I said, are you rooting for our Buckeyes? He said, I'll let you know in an hour.
That's right. That's right. I wasn't rooting for them.
Well, you're cold. McNabb just has to get rid of it. Heavy pressure from Pisa-Tinoe Samoa healthy and playing well again after signing last year, leaving St. Louis.
Yeah, and give the Bears some credit for what they're doing defensively right now. I mean, they're under a lot of pressure right now, having to keep this team in it. And, you know, for the most part this year, it's a defense that I think their ranking's a little exaggerated because they held Carolina and then Detroit under 200 yards of total offense. Other than that, teams have moved the ball, but they've just found a way to make a play.
Cooley trying to get to the first down marker. I think he's about a foot short.
You know, I thought it was awfully close. You saw Chris Cooley stretch out his arms trying to get it to the mark. Six passes. Todd Collins threw almost as many to the other team in that one.
Lester. First and five, and they convert to get a first down.
They're getting a standing ovation.
Little front running going on right now.
Well, I don't know if it's front running or not. I think they just want something to cheer about. It's a great sports town.
Sure is. Great town, period. Right at midfield, catch made by Earl Bennett.
You know, we still see, and I understand it. You know, Mike March, he's a guy who wants to get vertical. But what they have thrown has been the intermediate to shallow stuff. And, you know, so they can get the ball out of Cutler's hands. And he's still learning this offense. You know, there's a lot of things. Sometimes, you know, we talk about the offensive line not doing their job. Well, Cutler's still adjusting to this style. You know, it's much different from anything that he's done in the past.
They get a rack pull again, lining up off sides. That's a penalty. I think most fans, they just say, how in the world
offside,
does that happen?
Number 98 defense lined up in the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty, first down.
You know, those good pass rushers, they want to crowd the line as much as they can so they can get there as quickly as they can. And they've now caught a rack pull here twice on this series. But I mean, you think about it, and I think that's what has to be discussed at halftime for the Bears. As bad as it's been offensively, we can't play any worse. It's a 10-7 game, and if they do something here, it's either tied up or they're going to be leading at half.
Bears have all three timeouts along with a 2-minute warning. Quick throw, catch made again by Bennett. Greg Olson, the tight end. Johnny Knox to the 25, and that'll be a first down for Chicago.
That was close to being a lot better than what it was. Johnny Knox, he hits him on the back shoulder, which kind of forces him then to spin back out to his left. And had he been able to keep his feet, D'Angelo Hall, he had overrun it. And he likely is able to go up the sideline for a touchdown.
Knox on pace for a 1,000-yard receiving season. The Bears haven't had one of those since Marty Booker in the 2002 year. They're 4 out of 4 on his drive, a first and 10 to the 25-yard line. Short drop again, and Knox again.
I guess I shouldn't say they've converted third downs as much as they've gotten first downs. They've still yet to convert on a third down, but you see that throw there by Jay Cutler and another slant route. You know, those are high percentage throws working against D'Angelo Hall, and I think from that, then in the second half, assuming that you can get some type of protection up front, you start seeing the ball go down the field just a little bit more.
Under a minute to go. Forte. Dropped to the 10 by Rocky McIntosh.
And I'm sure
against Cleveland. To the end zone. Touchdown, Johnny Knox.
tell you what, Jay Cutler keeps that play alive. He got pressure to his blind side, and it shows the arm strength that Cutler has, because that was a ball that he barely got in there, and a dangerous throw there to the corner to Knox. You know, he spots him late right here, and he guns it in there, but yet LaRue saying, man, what's Cutler doing? But that's what they want from the quarterback here, and as they develop that kind of timing, then you're going to see the ball getting out. You're going to see guys catching the ball down the field, whether guys are turned loose up front or not.
Earl Bennett still on his feet, fights for additional yardage up to the 39. That's a first down.
You know, we talk about this offensive system that Mike Martz is putting in, and it's not just about the offensive line. It's not just about Jay Cutler. It's also about the receivers knowing where they're supposed to be, and it's the same offense that I ran in Dallas with Ernie Zampezi and Norv Turner. In fact, Mike Martz learned the offense under Ernie Zampezi, and what Ernie would say about the receivers, or to the receivers, be where you're supposed to be when you're supposed to be there. That sounds simple, but the quarterback just throws it on time, and then you've got to be in the right spot.
First down carry by Forte up to the 44-yard line, tripped up by London Fletcher.
You know, this running game, and Matt Forte specifically, I don't know that we really have gotten an opportunity to see what kind of runner he really is. I mean, when he's, you know, since he's been with the Bears, there hasn't been a lot of success running the football. I mean, he has yet to average 4 yards or better for a season running the ball. And I don't know how much of that's on him. We all know that the offensive line, you know, well before this year has had some issues, but they've just not been consistent in that part of their game for a while.
Blitz coming. And that's the first catch in 3 games for the tight end, Greg Olsen, and that'll be good enough for a first down up to midfield.
Well, the Redskins, they like to give a lot of different looks and move people around and try to confuse the offensive line. And, you know, Jay Cutler recognizes that he's going to have a free rusher. And so the ball's going to come out. And that's why you see Cutler get the ball out as quickly as he did. And Olsen was that outlet for him and made it into a positive play.
Bennett. Close to the end zone. Still waiting on an official signal. And apparently just shy of the goal line. But he's down at the 1. A big play nonetheless. And it's first and goal just outside the 1. Kevin Schaefer, an additional big body, is checked in for Chicago.
Well, we'll get an idea right here how much Marks believes in the running game.
Formation, Chester Taylor in the game. And they let Cutler take it, and he is met head on by Albert Haynesworth. Did he fumble the ball? Redskins say they have.
You worry about that on the quarterback sneak when you try to extend it across the goal line. There's a lot of bodies there to knock it out of your hand if you don't get it across the goal line.
Ruling on the field, the runner's forward progress was not stopped. The ball came loose, recovered by Washington. First down.
Wow. A huge play.
Well, Albert Haynesworth, he gets a push right there, you see, right over the top, and he gets contact first with Cutler. And as he's trying to extend the ball out, then someone else came in and knocked it loose.
Well, they challenged and lost a moment ago. And they don't challenge before this play. And on a first down, the quick hit to Santana Moss gives him a little bit of breathing room.
Yeah, if you challenge that, if you challenge the one with Earl Bennett as to whether or not he scored, I think it was worthwhile for Lovey then to challenge that play. And I don't know who he's talking with upstairs. But That looks awfully close to me. I mean, right? I don't know. I don't know if there's enough there that they would have overturned it.
What a huge swing from a momentum standpoint. fumbles, but he's able to fall back on it. Iwu was there providing the pressure.
Yeah, well, we talked about Julius Peppers and somebody stepping up opposite of him. Israel Adonijé does that on this play. He's able to go by Jamal Brown. He gets the pressure then on McNabb and holds him up. And Iwu was there to knock the ball out. And a good break by Washington and Donovan McNabb being able to recover that fumble.
Second down. DJ Moore, a second interception for a touchdown. A flag is down on the field.
Before the snap, delay of game, offense, half the distance to the goal, third down.
Wow. This has been an unbelievable sequence of plays. That touchdown wiped away on the delay of game on Fox. A horror show offensively through a quarter and a half for the Bears, and not a way to start it. On this drive as D'Angelo Hall steps in front of the Jay Cutler pass and snatches it away.
And that should never happen. Devin Hester has got to come back to the quarterback on that, and if nothing else, break up the pass.
First down for Washington at the 9-minute mark in the third quarter after the Jay Cutler interception. Terrain picks up two on first down.
And you go back and take a look at it. Here's the safety right here. D'Angelo Hall had no safety help whatsoever. Cutler gets the ball out on time. Initially, it looked like it was going to be an easy reception, but D'Angelo Hall cheats on the route, comes underneath it. You know, had they have run a go route there, it's an easy touchdown. But Devin Hester has to work back to the quarterback when you come out of the break. And at worst, then, that ball's incomplete and it's not intercepted.
Game. Chicago in front. It's the best protection he's had in a long time, and that's a drop by Fred Davis. Third drop today by a Washington receiver.
You know, D'Angelo Hall, there was a discussion this week about a conflict maybe between he and Jim Haslett, and a heated discussion during the week. Whether it was or whether it was or wasn't, you know, we don't really know. Jim Haslett certainly downplayed that, but D'Angelo Hall is a very confident corner. And he's a guy who will give up some things. He got beat last week in that Indianapolis game. But he gets beat a lot because he takes a lot of chances. And when he takes chances, a lot of times he's able to make plays, as we saw there. But that's what he's been doing in this league for a long time. He's cluing the quarterback, always looking to jump around.
Third down, McNabb down the field. And this one's intercepted. Danielle Manning. Up to the 41.
That's what Lovie Smith has been wanting to see from Daniel Manning for quite some time. An athletic guy lays out and makes one heck of an interception.
Meanwhile, Chester Taylor again in the game for Chicago. Matt Forte limped off early in the last series. And this is Taylor. Up to the 34. Let's check in back in Los Angeles with Kurt Menefee.
Ed Reed's first game back for the Ravens. He gets an interception, and the Baltimore offense takes advantage. Flea flicker, Flacco to Anquan Boldin, 34-yard touchdown. The Ravens have scored 17 points in a minute, 12 seconds, and now come back from 24-10 down to lead it 27-24. Tom, Troy, and Pam.
Well, a good one there and a good one here. That's been pretty. But it's a four-point spread, and Chester Taylor again with running room. Back-to-back first down carries for Taylor. Up to the 46.
Well, I like Chester Taylor. I like the things that he's able to do. He's a versatile player. Right now what we're seeing from Mike Martz is they're going with three wide receivers, and they're forcing the nickel package on the field, five defensive backs for the Redskins. It's the way Indianapolis played him last week. They ran the ball very well. in that ball game. And that's right now what the Bears are doing. They tried doing some of that in the first half, but the last two plays, that's why they've had the success running the ball.
Forte back in there, Foy Taylor, and he gets the screen. Another first down.
Well, these are all the things that Mike March kind of talked about that they wanted to do to start this game, and it's just now starting to come together. They tried the screen there in the first half to Matt Forte, had no chance on it then. They come back to it here on this drive, set up very well, and that's three real good plays right now on this drive.
12, 12, and 13 yards. Looking to start and sense for each team. The Bears going in the right direction.
Well, it all started with that drive to end the first half.
Forte met by London Fletcher. Well, Fletcher's been around a long time. His 13th year. 35-year-old Cleveland, Ohio native, and came into the NFL out of John Carroll. And who would have thought that he would have the career that he has had?
Well, the big thing is he shows up every week. You know, I mean, he's never missed a game. That's impressive enough for a middle linebacker. Last year he made his first Pro Bowl, and asked him how that felt. He said it felt good, but I got to be honest with you. I feel like I've been playing well enough to make the Pro Bowl for a lot of years. And I think he has, too.
Playing in his 199th consecutive game today. That's Taylor again. Taylor, along with Manu Maliuna and Julius Peppers, on the very first day of free agency. And here Taylor, 7 weeks into the year, only averaging 7 touches per game.
Paying him a lot of money for no more than he's gotten the ball. He got the ball quite a bit against Carolina, the way they were able to run the ball. But, you know, Chester Taylor is one of those guys that I think, you know, really makes your team. You know, it's one thing when you've got the superstars, but when you've got guys like Chester Taylor, more role players that are versatile and they create matchup problems for a defense, that's when you really start getting good. And I think that was a good signing for them, even though he hasn't been utilized probably as much as they anticipated when he did sign.
Third down, Cutler looking around. Catch made by Hester, who took a shot from Fletcher but hung on. First third down conversion today.
You know, you're going to see Matt Forte. He runs what they call a bullets route. They like it a lot. He's going to come here to the flat and then in the seam, and that's who Cutler wants to throw it to initially. Redskins cover that up good, and Cutler does a nice job of then getting off of it, coming back to Hester. And that's not an easy catch. That was pretty well contested right there by Washington, but a perfectly thrown pass, great concentration by Hester.
Forte to the 15. That third down conversion ended a string of 28 in a row unsuccessful third down conversions with Jay Cutler at quarterback.
Well, that's what they want to do with Forte, is get him out on the edge. And Aroma Shadu comes down and makes just enough of a block there on Arakpo that sprung Forte then on the edge. You know, we've seen it now ever since that last drive of the first half. This is a confident offense, the way they're operating. That's how quickly it can turn.
Gain of 3 on first down for Forte. Cutler, a quiet opening quarter. And as Troy mentioned, that drive just before halftime to put him in front, he's been mighty good since.
Well, and I'll give Jay Cutler some props, because for a guy who's taken the pounding that he's taken, some of that's been his fault too, I might add. But even having said that, he hasn't complained. And this is a tough son of a gun, and he keeps getting up. Forget about the concussion, he did miss the one game, but he keeps getting back in that huddle with those other 10 guys, and he plays the best he can.
Nice open field tackle made by D'Angelo Hall, and a big third down upcoming. If you're the Redskins, you can hold them to a field goal here. You know, even with all your struggles on offense, much like we talked about Chicago in the first half with all their struggles, and they were only down 3 points.
Yeah, I think that's what, you know, for Washington to have allowed Chicago to get down to the 1-yard line and then not give up any points, if they can hold them to a three-point field goal here, that'd be a victory.
Blitz coming. And D'Angelo Hall snatches it away and races down the sideline with a man to beat. He got a block, and Hall will go the distance. My, oh, my.
On that last play, and then you consider the fact that the Bears probably would have gotten seven if Cutler doesn't fumble on the quarterback sneak.
Olson gets away from McIntosh for an additional 5 yards, and that'll be a first down to the 31.
Well, they figured some things out here offensively, and I think the biggest thing is that, you know, Cutler's starting to get better protection. And that's usually how this thing happens, you know. A lot of times you come in and the pass rushers for the other team, they're pretty cranked up too, and so things happen pretty fast, and they happen fast for those offensive linemen. And then as you settle in, the protection gets a little bit better, those defensive guys get a little bit more tired, and you get a little bit more time.
Cutler sacked by Arakpo, his second sack today, is seventh of the year. Broken up by McIntosh, and then it looked like Olson made the catch. Yes, it is a reception.
Now, Jay Cutler just gives Olson an opportunity. Now, this is great coverage. See, Olson, he just goes up. I mean, Rocky McIntosh was in perfect position. Cutler, because of the height advantage that Olson has, throws it up, and even then took great concentration on Olson's part to bring that one in. Heck of a play.
They convert a third down for the second time in a game. Devin Hester. Good tackle by Hall. Arakpo is chopped down by Olin Krutz.
Well, we talked about the fact that Olson hadn't had any catches the last couple of weeks, and you know, here's a guy who led their team in receptions last year, and trying to get him the ball more. But when you've got someone like him with his kind of size and his athletic ability, it was good to see Jay Cutler just give him a chance, especially on third and long.
Forte on second and four. That's a first down.
Starting to get that running game going a little bit better here too. Early on, they couldn't get anything going with the running game. Looking at second and long each time they attempted it on first down, and we're starting to see them open some things up a little bit more now also.
60 rushing yards in the third quarter after getting only 6 rushing yards in the first half.
Well, they're still going to the 3 wide receiver sets, trying to get Washington and nickel people, 5 DBs to run it.
Forte fumbled the ball, and another Chicago turnover. Fourth of the game. McIntosh stripped it away.
Here for a non-quarterback, second most fumbles in the National Football League, right behind Adrian Peterson.
3 big turnovers here in the second half for Chicago. And Ryan Terrain took a big hit but stays on his feet. Harris making contact along with Jennings. Let's go back to Kurt Menefee in Los Angeles.
Bengals were down to the Falcons 24-3 at halftime, but 22 unanswered points in the third quarter changed it. Adam, don't call me Pac-Man Jones, with a strip and return, 62 yards for the touchdown, and the Bengals lead it 25-24 to start the fourth quarter. Tom, Troy, and Pam.
17-14 here, Kurt. Terrain. A first down and then some.
still on his feet all the way to the 42-yard line.
Now, I talked about Chris Cooley earlier in the game and how good he is as a blocker, and you're going to see him motion across. He had motioned across already. You can see him right here, 47. And he just does a nice job on the kick out enough. And then Ryan Terrain, it's hard to bring him down when you're going down around his ankles, as we saw there by Pisatino Isamoah. And once he gets up ahead of steam, he's a difficult man to bring to the ground.
Keelan Williams, a rookie out of LSU. Picks up maybe a yard. We invite you to go to NFL.com's Game Center for Week 5 live game stats. Week 7 as well. You can have fan discussions, in-game video highlights, and more only at NFL.com/scores. Everything going on in Week 7. Terrain, another big run inside the 25 all the way down to the 22.
Well, that's that stretch play of Ryan Terrain, and you know they do a good job up front, and then Ryan Terrain's going to put his foot in the ground and get going north and south. Chris Cooley once again, and Matt Tuina, he had a chance to make a play and he fails to make it. Like I said, if you're going to hit Ryan Terrain, you want to get a hold of him at the line of scrimmage, because once he starts up the field and gets ahead of steam going, he's a big physical guy.
55 of those 89 yards rushing for Terrain have come on this drive, trying to add to it, and will. And the ball is loose. Picked up by Tillman. So Washington gives it away in the red zone. Josh Bullocks. Third interception for D'Angelo Hall. And the question bears repeating. Which team wants to win this game?
Well, you see Jay Cutler, Johnny Knox has got to stay on the route. You're going to see that D'Angelo Hall breaks across his face, but Johnny Knox has got to stay on the move. You can't, when there's a route that's contested, you can't just then stop on the route, because that's what happens when you do.
Last five possessions for Chicago, each possession ending in a turnover.
You know, Marks just looks like he's about to vomit over there on the sidelines with everything that's happened here today, and you know he knows it too. You know, you try to get the ball out something quick, and oh, Johnny Knox, just that's going to look like it's on Jay Cutler, but that's on Johnny Knox.
Terrain took a big hit from Julius Peppers.
Take another look at this. It's a slant route, and you've got to work hard. You've got to do everything you can to get under that guy's face and break it up. And Jay Cutler was going there right from the snap of the ball, and this is Mike Martz's reaction to it all.
Julius Peppers shaking up on that first down carry, but he stays in the game. Cooley loses the ball and just punches it out of bounds alertly. Ball is loose. And
go ahead.
Washington covers it up. And out comes a field goal unit. And again, Adonijé right in the thick of the action.
Yeah, he comes along McNabb's backside, and a good job by him. Israel Adonijé has played very well. We talked about, you know, them needing somebody to step up opposite of Julius Peppers, and and they've gotten that today. They activated Barry Turner. They thought that they would get more than jumping routes. I think I'd try a double move on him here real soon. Right now he's one-on-one on Hester.
Well, they go right to Hester. That's the kind of day it's been for both teams.
You're right. Who wants it?
7:40. That would have been a first down, and Knox dropped it. Let's go back to Kurt Menefee in Los Angeles.
Well, no dropping this one. Kerry Collins in at quarterback for the injured Vince Young all day long. And, well, this play lasted all day long. 80 yards, Kenny Britt scores his second touchdown of the game. What legal issue off the field? He's a big-time scoring machine. Still, the Eagles lead at 19-17 in the fourth. Tom, Troy, and Pam.
All right, a third down for Jay Cutler and the Bears. Under 7.5 to go. Complete to Forte, but this may come back.
Holding, number 73, offense. 10-yard penalty, still third down.
That's Jamarcus Webb, the right tackle. Number 73, you're going to see Andre Carter is who's taking the inside rush. And, you know, I didn't see much when it happened, and I didn't see anything there. I thought they might have gotten a hold on the other side with the Rakpo, but that's a tough one there. As we know, these third down conversions have been tough to come by, and they had a nice one there to Forte.
So third and four becomes third and 14. Off the helmet of Landry and all the way back into the arms of Chris Williams. That ball hit Landry in the head.
Both Santana Moss and Donovan McNabb.
Flag down. McNabb sacked at the 35-yard line by Tino Isamoah.
Well, he just got a free run at Donovan McNabb, and I don't even think it's gonna matter. Looks like they're calling offsides on Chicago.
Offside, number 71. Defense lined up in a neutral zone. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
That is a huge call.
He just gets a free run right here on Donovan. And Artis Hicks, he blocks out. You got to protect the inside gap first. He doesn't see the blitz, and there's no chance for McNabb, but all for naught.
So you get the sack on third down, but the penalty turns it into a third and one.
Yeah, now they got every play in the playbook at their disposal.
He didn't get there. So the Bears are going to get it back one more time.
Yeah, I just thought Ryan Terrain went into the line there a little bit tentative, and he tried cutting that back. And
good protection on first down and thrown behind Devin Hester.
Yeah, we've seen a few of those from Jay Cutler here today, and he had good protection there. And I don't know, you know, if it's, it looked like he set up pretty good. You know, sometimes, as we've seen on the interception that he had when he was trying to fit one there on into the corner, you know, he'll throw off his back foot, but, you know, that's a ball that quite simply you just got to be able to make if you're going to be an NFL quarterback.
Reception made by Johnny Knox, and that'll be good enough for a first down up to the 31. Clock continues to run, 3:15.
You know, I'm still a little surprised that they haven't taken a shot at D'Angelo Hall. You know, right there, Johnny Knox again going up against D'Angelo Hall, and he's playing him pretty tight. We've seen him jump some routes, and we haven't yet seen a double move on him. And know, to do that, you've got to get some time in the pocket. Maybe that's why Mike Martz hasn't called it, as he's so worried about giving up another sack.
Well, he finds Knox down the middle of the field. Another first down to the 48.
And you kind of wonder where Johnny Knox's confidence level is right now. That previous catch that he had, you know, he was pretty secure with the football and just wanted to make sure he caught it. And he comes right back and makes another reception.
Deep ball. D'Angelo Hall with his fourth interception of the game. So much was written last week in the loss to Indianapolis about all the dropped interceptions by the Redskins secondary. Not today.
Well, watch D'Angelo Hall. He turns and bails right at the snap of the ball, and so there was never a chance to complete this one. You know, Jay Cutler wants to take a shot, but there's no double move to get D'Angelo Hall to jump it. And as I said earlier, what D'Angelo likes to do is clue the quarterback. So he's watching Jay this entire time. And then Jay throws one up, but Johnny Knox never got up on top of D'Angelo Hall. There was never an opportunity to complete that pass. I'm surprised that Jay turned it loose the way he did. They had a chance late to still come out on top.
Bears spending a timeout. They have one left. They're trying to come up with a stop. And a first down catch made by Cooley. Right at the first down marker. And that takes us to the 2-minute.
NFC is pretty interesting still.
Terrain across midfield. And that's a first down. It's the 16th most in the history of the league. So a homecoming for Shanahan, for McNabb. And they beat the Redskins beat the Bears. Final count of 17-14. We'll have some bonus coverage coming.